Now, based on this, the another diagram will be like this. This is octahedral. D orbitals, stage 2. This is easy. This is T2G. This is delta T. This is stage 1, stage 2, and after splitting. In yesterday, a student called me and asked about the designation. Here it is. I have written T2G and EG. In every textbook, it is given as EG and T2G, but in the app that is provided by the CBSE, there this G was removed. Don't get panic. There is a relation between these two. Delta T is equal to 4 by 9 delta O. This indicates tetrahedral splitting is less when compared to octahedral splitting. So if this is less, then automatically electron will go into the higher orbitals. So there is no question of low spin complexes in tetrahedral. Hence, in tetrahedral complexes, low spin complexes are very, very rare. In octahedral, yesterday I told you, first electron comes here, second, third, now fourth electron, maybe here or maybe here. Three electrons will be 1, 2, 3. So up to three electrons, first electron, likewise I'm giving T2G, 1, 2, 3. T2G, 1, 2, 3. Now, the fourth electron in weak ligands. In weak ligands, tell me, in weak ligands, that means this is less. In weak ligands, this is less. Therefore, electron jumps to higher level. If it is a strong ligand, this is more. Then electron fades up. Instead of going to higher energy level, pairing is easier. If this gap is higher, that means in strong ligands, pairing takes place. In weak ligands, pairing does not take place. Therefore, next, T2G, 1, 2, 3, EG, 4, right? And EG 5. Right or wrong? 1, 2, 3 over. Then fourth electron enters here because it is a weak ligand. And fifth, EG. Next, sixth electron comes back here. Therefore, next, sixth, T2G 6. Seventh also here. Eighth also here. Now, ninth goes up. Therefore, it will be like this, EG 9. Tenth also likewise. This is the configuration. In strong ligands, tell me, as it is, T2G 1, 2, 3, T2G 1, 2, 3. So in strong ligands, this is more, therefore pairing takes place. In T2G 1, 2, 3, next 4, next 5, next 6. That is over. Next, EG 7, 8. This is in case of strong ligands. Okay, now, if electron comes here, then you have to multiply with what energy? -0.4. If electron comes here, -0.4 delta. So, if there are 6 electrons, 6 into -24. Here also 4 electrons, 4 into, if here it enters in, then it multiplied with 0.6 delta. So 4 electrons, 4 into 6, 24 plus 24. 6 electrons, 6 into 4, -24, get cancelled. That means crystal field stabilization energy is 0 there. If you come to this, what is a crystal field energy? stabilization energy in weak ligand about this up to 5 for a D5 configuration. For a D5 configuration in weak ligands, crystal field stabilization energy, we have to write the electronic configuration. 3 electrons are here. 3 into minus 4, minus 12. 2 electrons here. 2 into plus 6, plus 12. Therefore, minus 12 and plus 12 cancel. Therefore, for a D5 system, crystal field stabilization energy is 0. For a D5 system, crystal field stabilization energy is 0. For a D6 system, up to here 0, then the electron enters here, therefore it will be minus 4. For a D7 system, it will be minus 12, sorry, minus 8. For a D8 system, it will be minus 12. So likewise, you have to calculate. In crystal field stabilization energy, in case of strong ligand, for a D6 system, the crystal field stabilization energy is 6 into minus 4, therefore minus 24. Minus 24. In weak ligands, it is just minus 4. In strong ligands, it is minus 24. Based on that, you have to calculate this. This is the type of configuration you have to write. The similar mechanism is applied to here also. Once electron enters in the lower energy, it should be represented as minus. Energy is released. If it goes up, energy is absorbed. Therefore, minus 6. So, this is the energy 0.6 delta T and 0.4 delta T. It is completely reverse. Whenever electron enters into the lower energy, please consider minus. Whenever electron enters into higher energy, please consider plus. So this is a very important. In tetrahedral complexes, almost all are high spin. Because the energy difference is less, therefore electron goes to higher energy levels. In strong ligands, EZ1, 2, 1, 2, third electron also here, fourth also here. Next, T2G, fifth, sixth, seventh, next, eighth, nine, ten. This is in case of strong ligand. In weak ligands, EG, 1, 2, 1 and 2. In weak ligands, 1 and 2, then electron goes here. So 1 and 2. Next, T2, G, 3, 4, 5. Next, EG, 6, electron goes into this. Next, 7. Next, T2G, 8, 9, and 10. This is the configuration. So for a D5 system, for this also, crystal field stabilization is 0. For this also, crystal field stabilization is 0. In which case? Weak ligand. In weak ligands, crystal field stabilization energy for a D5 system is 0. In strong or weak, for a D10 system, crystal field stabilization is 0. Because in D10, 6 electrons here, 4 electrons here, 4 electrons here, 6 electrons here. In textbook, it is given as, here it is given as 3 by 5. This is given as 2 by 5. 2 by 5 means 0.4. 3 by 5 means 0.6. Same. Next. The advantage of crystal field theory is, it explains magnetic behavior, colors also. But valence band theory does not explain the colors. It was able to explain the magnetic behavior, color of complexes. Color of complexes. In S-block salts, all S-block salts are colorless. That is undisputed. But S-block salts can be identified with the flame test. Try to recollect. And potassium has a lilac. Barium has apple green. Calcium has brick red. All these because of excitation, de-excitation of valence electrons under the, that is a heating, that is on the flame, that is called flame photometry. Now, come to this complex. For example, consider this. CuSO4, copper sulfate, it is colorless. Anhydrous copper sulfate is colorless. This was used in detection of water molecule. If water molecule comes in contact with copper sulfate, it becomes blue. That is called blue vitriol. So anhydrous copper sulfate is colorless. But CuSO4, 5H2O, has blue color. Some magic because of water molecules, hydrated molecules. So this causes the color. This is heated strongly. If water molecule is removed by calcination, then it forms anhydrous copper sulfate. Anhydrous copper sulfate is colorless. Hydrated copper sulfate is blue color. So there is something we have to understand. What the thing that is being carried by the water molecule? Water molecule causes some abnormal properties here. Now, go to crystal field theory. Water molecules are ligands. The complex is written like this. Cu, H2O, four times. SO4, H2O. So how many ligands are you able to see in the complex? Four. Maybe tetrahedral or square planar, whatever it may be, there are four ligands. These four ligands certainly approach towards the metal atom, either along the axis or in between the axis, but depending upon the shape. Leave aside, I'll let you know later. So four ligands definitely approach towards copper ion. As a result, the d orbital splits. This splitting of d orbital causes the energy difference in the d subshell. Likewise, I'll give take you one more example. Titanium, H2O, six times positive charge. It has purple color. Right? Now look at this. Titanium atomic number 22. Configuration 3D2 4S2. Titanium plus 3. It is plus 3, right? Now, titanium is in which oxidation state? Plus 3. Plus 3 means how do you write? 3D1 4S0. Right? How many ligands are there? Six ligands are definitely octahedral or not octahedral. In octahedral complexes, ligands approach along the axis or between the axis? Along the axis. Therefore, d orbital splits. Now, for this complex, it should be written like this. One, two, three, four, five. This is a D1 system. This is also a D1 system. This is stage one. This is next. This is also. Now look at carefully. As long as electron resides in any one of the pi orbitals, it does not show color because there is no electron excitation, de-excitation. But here, this complex undergoes splitting due to the presence of ligand. Now look at this electron comes here. This is in ligands. In ligands. Splitting takes place. Right? I think this is stage one. This is the stage two. Now this is stage three. This stage arises only in presence of complexes. That is in presence of ligands. Now look at, if a light falls on, this electron jumps to here. Then the complementary color arises. If light falls on the complex, this electron jumps to here. That is called a transition. The transition is called DD transition, not shell to shell transition. So this electron may be jumped here. So here, there is a possibility of DD transition. So all complex compounds are colored because of DD transition. That color is due to ligands. If I change this ligand, the color is also changing. Because a ligand is nothing but a charge, which makes the difference here. water may be weaker ion, so this will be less. If it is carbon monoxide, it will be more. It will be cyanide, it will be less. It will be ammonia, it is less when compared to cyanide. So ligand to ligand, this field changes. If this field changes, the energy difference changes. If energy difference changes, wavelength changes. If wavelength changes, the color changes. So this is one of the important application of the crystal field theory. It successfully explains the colors of the transition metal ions. If there is unpaired electron, it has color. If ligand changes, the color also changes. For example, I will give you one more example. Cu, NH3, four times, plus two. This color is green, not blue, or deep blue rather. It is water, it is ammonia. Ammonia is a strong ligand than water. Therefore, intensity of color changes. This is a blue color, this is a deep blue color. The deep blue color. This point you can observe in the fifth group. Ammonia has a ligand. It forms complexes likewise. Color of the complexes also changes with the oxidation state. Cu plus 1, one type of color. Cu plus 2, another type. If oxidation changes, electron changes. If electron changes, color changes. If ligand changes, this changes, color changes. Therefore, colors of the complexes depends upon the strength of the ligand, depends upon the oxidation state, depends upon the type of ligand also. So different factors are there. This is about the colors, color of the complexes. If this is heated, water molecule is removed, it is a colorless. Why? Because if water is removed, there is no chance of this. It will be like this. If this is, then there is no transition. So if there is splitting only, then transition. If splitting is absent, no transition. The colors are due to complex formation by the ligands. In textbook, one example is given. I'll just tell you. Nickel, H2O, four times, is actually green. This is six times. Is actually green. Here it is plus two. If this is mixed with ethylene diamine is a bidentate ligand. That is the NH2, CH2, NH2. In next case, if ethylene diamine is added in this, then this will be. Instead of two ligands, ethylene diamine is written. In this case, the color changes to blue. Why? Because the ligand is changing. Now, next case, nickel, H2O, two times, EN taken twice. Now the ligand strength increases. Water molecules and ligands changes. And here it is, so this purple, light pink. And in next case, Ni, EN3, and plus two, violet. So this is an evidence for the explanation that I have given so far. If ligand changes, color changes. Strength of the ligand changes, the color also changes. So if water is taken, green. If ethylene diamine is taken, one ligand, blue. Two ligands are taken, purple. Four, three ligands are taken, violet. This is to be remembered. In the textbook, it is clearly given in the pictorial method also. Test tubes are given, in the test tubes some colors are also given. This is about the color of the complexes. So I'll give you some more examples. Look at this. K4, Fe, CN6. K3, Fe, CN6. Both colors are same or different? Definitely different. Though ligands are same. Why? Because this is potassium ferrocyanide. This is potassium ferricyanide. In this potassium ferrocyanide and ferricyanide, in this plus two oxidation state, here it is, plus three oxidation state. If oxidation state changes, colors also changes. Now tell me, what is the color of this? Na2. Color of this. Look at this. oxidation state of zinc, Zn plus 2. Right? Now the configuration of Zn plus 2. 3d10, 4s2 actually, 2 electrons lost, 3d10. Now, in case, even after splitting, the complex will be like this, right? If it is right or wrong, 4 electrons, 6 electrons, because coordination number is only 4. If I take it as a tetrahedral, then it will be like this. Tell me, these 4 electrons at the bottom, 6 electrons at the top, is there any transition? No question of transition, no question of change of electrons from one position to another position. Therefore, what is the color of this complex? No color. Hence, zinc salts, zinc complexes do not have colors. Titanium plus 4 complex has color. Now check it. 3D2, 4S2, actually titanium. In plus 4 state, it has configuration 3D, 0, 4S. So titanium plus 4 salts are colorless. Now tell me, scandium salts are colored or colorless? Scandium atomic number 21. Therefore, it is a 3D1, 4S2. In plus 3 state, it is just a 3D0, 4S0. This is Sc plus 3. No unpaired electron. No unpaired electron. So these salts are not colored. Titanium plus 3 is colored. Why? Because the configuration is 3D1, 4S0. Magnetic behavior. Magnetic behavior is simply explained. Already we studied the valence bond theory, in which we got the number of unpaired electrons also there to explain the hybridization. So based on that, definitely we can explain the magnetic movement. For example, if one electron is there, then magnetic movement is 1.7 Bohr magneton. If two unpaired electrons, 2.8 Bohr magneton. If three unpaired electrons, 3.8 Bohr magneton. If four unpaired electrons, 4.8 Bohr magnetons. If five unpaired electrons, 5.8 Bohr magneton. It is simply written as magnetic movement. Magnetic movement is simply is equal to N.8. In textbook, it is written as N into N plus 2 under root Bohr magneton. Instead of remembering this, just to get the unpaired electron, put 0.8. This is a simple way. For example, if there are 4 unpaired electrons, 4 into 6 under root 24, nearly 4.8. If there are 5 unpaired electrons, 5 into 7, 35, under root 36, nearly 5.8. So based on unpaired electron, it is simply remembered. So it is just N.8, where N is number of unpaired electron. Metal, carbonyls. Metal carbonyls. Examples. Nickel, tetra carbonyl. Or pentacarbonyl iron. Hexacarbonyl cobalt. Hexacarbonyl cobalt. So these are all carbonyls. Likewise, some more examples are given. Octacarbonyl, dimanganese carbonyl. There is a dimanganese complex. Octacarbonyl, hexacarbonyl cobalt, octacarbonyl dimanganese. Likewise, complexes are given. For what I am discussing this, in this complex, in carbonyl, synergic effect is there. This is a new word to you. Synergic effect is observed in carbonyls. Synergic effect is observed in carbonyls. What is synergy? Synergy literally means together. There are, for example, if two business people combine together, their synergy increases. That means after a combination, their strength increases. So symbiotic, synergy, these are all synonyms, combination, combining together. So synergetic effect means together they are very strong. Why? Because, for example, metals are here. These are orbitals. Carbon monoxide is a good ligand, very good ligand. Why? Because carbon can donate a lone pair and also having some orbitals. These orbitals are molecular orbitals. In carbon monoxide, the D2 bond is like this. Carbon monoxide, carbon is a ligand, not oxygen. Carbon acts as a ligand. Carboxyhemoglobin is a very stable complex. Once carbon monoxide is inhaled, it proves fatal. It causes death. Why? Because carbon monoxide binds very strongly to the metal. That binding is very strong because of this synergetic effect. As a result, the carbon monoxide acts as a powerful ligand, all the ligand. Hence, we have listed the carbon monoxide as the strongest ligand in the spectrochemical series. Now, this is a dative bond from carbon. At the same time, metal also able to donate the electron likewise. This bond is called pi bond. This bond is called sigma bond. Likewise, it can be represented. And after that, metal has filled d orbitals. That filled d orbitals overlaps, this sideways overlapping of the empty orbital of molecular orbital of carbon. So this is the synergy. Look at the observe it. Carbon monoxide is a ligand. Carbon donates the lone pair. And it forms a dative bond to the metal atom. And the central metal atom has completely filled d orbitals. So that is a bond. And after the formation of sigma bond, metals are giving back electrons to the carbon of molecular orbital, empty molecular orbital. This is empty molecular orbital. So it appears one more bond formed between metal and carbon. Between carbon and metal, initially sigma bond, that is called dative bond. And after the formation, metal is able to donate the filled d orbital electrons to the empty molecular orbital of carbon to form a pi bond. As a result, the strength of the metal and carbon monoxide becomes very, very strong. These are not two bonds. It is a pi bond. Pi bond is due to sideways overlapping. This is upper lobe and lower lobe that is available in the filled d orbital. This is about the metal carbon ions. And next, stability of complexes. It is just like equilibrium concept. The complex formation is taken as like this. Metal plus ligand, ML. This is equilibrium, ML. Metal plus ligand. That is just a common example. If you write K1 here, equilibrium constant, you will be writing like this. I think you know very well all these products by reactants. That is K1 equilibrium constant. And ML combines with one more ligand to form ML2. In this case, K2, then it can be written as products concentration by reactants concentration. ML2 plus ligand changes to ML3. Here you have to write K3, which is equal to ML3 concentration by ML2. Right? Likewise, say, in equilibrium, by adding this, we get this, get cancelled off. So M plus 3L gives ML3. Say, this is K4, but in the test book, it is written as BN. Well, likewise, so it's K4. So here, K4 is equal to in equilibrium. By adding all these three, then K4 is equal to K1 into K2 into K3. In such a case, then it is written as, in the textbook, it is represented as K1 into K2 into K3 into K4 and so on, KN. In such a case, by applying logarithms, log bn is equal to log k1 plus k2 plus log k3 plus and so on log kn. More the equilibrium constant, more is its stability. Reciprocal of this constant is nothing but instability. If you reverse this, stability is reversed. Therefore, more the k value, more is the stability. Reciprocal of this value, nothing but instability complexes. This is about the stability of the complexes.